This is the second part of the video dedicated to how to draw a circle resting on an inclined plane, isometric perspective. I recommend that you begin to see the first part since some of the issues discussed here there will be assumed already known. What will solve this simplified piece, formed by a wedge and a cylinder? We will focus on drawing the circumference of the cylinder base by despondency and affinity. The layout of the wedge and the height of the cylinder already explained in the first part. The abatement process is based on the true draw-faced shape in which the cylinder base rests. Then, the first thing we need to know are the measures that face. In our example, there is a wide rectangle measure A and unknown along with the data we were given in the statement. But we got easily drawing the elevation and taking him as R. That measure cannot be obtained because of the prospect and is not parallel to the axis of the isometric perspective is not true extent. I remind that the dimensions and the view's true magnitudes are used, and when these measures the relocator perspective should apply the reduction coefficient when working with an isometric perspective, or not use it if you want to draw a picture isometric. Known measures the draw supporting her face on one of its sides in perspective. But we must be careful to do it on one side that is parallel to the isometric axis. Then, we cannot build on the long side for not being parallel to the axis. And although we do empennasmos and the measurements obtained in the elevation and perspective not coincide, yes, we can do it on the short side being parallel to the axis, y, isometric axis. From that side got the other two sides perpendicular and give the measure of length r. Do not forget to apply the reduction coefficient to measure r. If it is applied to the whole perspective, or not if you are not using it. From here I do not remember more, but keep it in mind for the full year. Here we can raise an affinity between the folded box and perspective. The axis of affinity is the common side. A couple of related points are the vertices of rectangles and perspective shot in affinity address is the union of those points. With these elements we can find the prospect of any form that is on the face using any of the methods we have studied in affinity. We place the center of the circle in the gloom with measures E and F. With its diameter, h, as the drawer a circle is in abating forms are preserved. We determine the center and the perspective following the classical methods of affinity. He joins one of the corners of the rectangle with the center to the axis of affinity and from there, connects with its cognate vertex. With a direction parallel to the affinity that starts from the center, we determine the center of the ellipse. The above procedure may be repeated for points of the ellipse. For example, we choose a point on the circumference and joined with the center of the circle, extending to the axis of affinity. We join with the center of the ellipse and a direction parallel to the affinity of the point get its cognate. This can be repeated as often as we want points. If we want the points parallel to the sides of the face axis, we act the same way. The axis which is parallel to the axis of affinity will remain parallel and the ellipse and its ends are achieved parallel to the direction of affinity. The other two points that unite with what we already have and we extend to the axis of affinity. We unite with its cognate and again with a direction parallel to the affinity we obtain. As I mentioned in the first part, these are two conjugate diameters, and from them you can get the other points of the ellipse. We can also determine the principal axes of the ellipse. We join the center of the circle and the ellipse, where we find the bisector and cut the axis of affinity, take it as the center of a circle of radius, to the center of the circle or ellipse. The cut-off points of this circle with the axis of affinity binding with the center of the circle and the ellipse. on the points where the circumference cuts are drawn parallel to the direction of affinity and have vertices of the ellipse I its main axis. In the first part, one explained how to get the cylinder axis, and if we drew a line perpendicular to the cylinder axis through the center of the ellipse at the point of cutting, this were the contact points of the contours of the cylinder. Thanks to the affinity, we can determine these points in an accurate way, and we extend perpendicular to the cylinder axis to the axis of affinity and then joined with the center of the circle, where the chord are the points that we seek. With a pair of parallel to the direction of affinity, we get the exact points from those leaving the apparent contours of the cylinder. These procedures are not unique. Any procedure known both affinity as conic curves can be applied through the gloom, as we could determine the principal axes of the ellipse and a pair of conjugate axes. We could use the procedures tangent to an ellipse known his address to search for the contact points of the contours, or method to find cut points of a line in an ellipse, or obtaining ellipses known the principal axes or conjugates or other equally valid exposed. The procedure obate and implement an affinity is one of the most powerful resources we have, as it has many applications besides being fast and accurate. So, if we were to take angles on the inclined face or complex shapes, despondency facilitates us greatly. I hope that with this application you have understood that the affinity, which is studied in plane geometry, is tremendously useful for systems of representation. In future videos, we explain how to obtain elliptical cylinder sections to be sectioned by a plane, or how to draw curves support of cylindrical parts whose axes are not perpendicular to the planes of projection, isometric perspectives. A greeting from Antonio Castilla. Do not forget to subscribe, click I like, and visit trazoida.com.